wonderful. Strong isolated storms and cloudy skies near Cape Canaveral forced the shuttle Atlantis to stay in space a little longer. Now, here is what the skies look like today near the Kennedy Space Center. This video comes to us from one of our WeatherBug cameras in Florida. Atlantis had two opportunities to land today, but NASA decided against it, saying showers and clouds were too close to the landing strip. The shuttle will have five more chances over the next 3 days. NASA says conditions look promising tomorrow afternoon.
Those WeatherBug cameras should come in handy, don't they?
We do.
We've got some other images coming into us tonight as well.
Yes, we do. I want you to look at this photograph. It's a time exposure taken last night as the International Space Station and the Space Shuttle Atlantis went across. Boy, we had emails today and phone calls. It was amazing, the response to folks who've gone out there and looked at it. And courtesy of Michael Durr of Westmont, Illinois. Michael, by the way, is Creative Services Director at our sister station, CLTV. On the left is the International Space Shuttle, and this is time exposed, so you can see it streaking across the sky, and that line on the right is Atlantis, following it a little bit, as viewed around 9:55 last evening, high in the sky, just as Dan Joyce, our astronomer, said it would be there. And Dan just called us to tell us if tomorrow there are not clouds in the sky, tomorrow night we may see it again. We'll fill you in on details tomorrow.
And that's the news for this Thursday night. I'm Allison Payne.
I'm Tom Negeman. For Rich King, Tom Skilling, and all of us here, have a great night.